In 1949, the USSR Army first adopted the AK rifle and the 7.62x39 cartridge. 10 years later, it was replaced by the modernized AKM. However, in the mid-60s, a different path was chosen. The Soviets began rearming from the 7.62 caliber AK to the 5.45. But why did they do this? Why did Kalashnikov consider abandoning the 7.62 in favor of the 5.45 a big mistake? And what new caliber did Russia recently create to replace it? So, in 1943, a big technical council was held in the USSR, introducing four rifles. The German Mauser 98K using the 7.92x57 rounds, and the more recent STG-44 using smaller 7.92x33 ammo, alongside with two American rifles, and one Garand with 7.62x63 cartridge, and the new M1 carbine with 7.62x33 cartridge. It became clear that the leading countries began adopting lighter weapons. For a reason, the war had shown that most battles were fought at ranges of up to 400 meters. Therefore, an overly large cartridge could be eliminated by creating a lighter cartridge based on its cartridge case. At the time, the USSR decided to create a new weapon. They prepared four calibers, 4.5, 6.5, as well as 5.6 and 7.62. Among them, the 5.6 was recognized as the most effective, but due to limited finances, the industry could not provide chrome plating of barrels for it. So, they chose the 7.62. This is how the 7.62x39 and the AK rifle appeared. They remained in service for many years. However, in the mid-60s, the Soviets learned about the new American M16 rifle under the 5.56x45 cartridge. That's when they remembered their 5.6 caliber and began to test the feasibility of returning to it. It turned out that the new cartridge could provide a huge number of advantages. The fact is that for a long time, the Soviets could not overcome the high recoil and insufficient accuracy of the old AKM. They created folding bipods, double compensators, hung a second magazine under the handguard, and even implemented a gyroscope in the receiver. However, all these developments made the weapon either too heavy, too expensive, or too bulky and loud, whereas the new caliber solved all the problems. By the way, the 5.6 caliber is in fact the 5.45. The 5.45 is the caliber of the AK-74 barrel, which is measured by the rifling fields. The bullet itself has the real caliber of 5.6mm. This is how the AK-74 and the 5.45x39mm cartridge appeared. The new rifle surpassed the old AKM in terms of overall combat effectiveness by 1.52 times. The recoil level was reduced, which increased accuracy, precision, and comfort of shooting. Due to this, the fatigue of the soldier has also decreased. Initial velocity and penetrating ability increased, and more hollow point trajectory allowed to increase the firing distance from 360 to 420 meters. At the same time, the weight of ammunition was reduced, which allowed to increase ammunition capacity by 1.5 times without exceeding the previous load. It would seem to be only pluses, but then why did Mikhail Kalashnikov consider the rejection of the 7.62 in favor of the 5.45 a big mistake, for which the USSR would have to pay 30 years later? He thought it was a premature decision, because in the coming decades, armies would be equipped with armor so protective that the 5.45 would not be able to penetrate it. The development of the 5.45 would require a lot of resources, and the result would be unpredictable. Therefore, Kalashnikov considered spending on the 5.45 to be a waste of money. We have no official confirmation of his words, and it is quite understandable. After all, it was against the government's decision. But if Kalashnikov really said that, how right was he? In fact, the 5.45 round is even ahead of the 7.62 in terms of penetration. The 7.62 armor-piercing incendiary round, called BZ, can penetrate a 7mm thick armor plate from 200 meters. Meanwhile, the new armor-piercing 5.45, called 7N39, penetrates 5mm plate from 550 meters. Of course, the 7.62x39 cartridge has a number of advantages. It is easier to silence, has higher kinetic energy, and less ricochet. However, taking into account all other characteristics, it is more suitable as a highly specialized tool for special operations, whereas the 5.45 is more suited for the regular army. It not only provided combat advantages, but also reduced the amount of resources spent on production of ammo and training of soldiers. Today, the 545 is still doing its job, but from the looks of it, it may soon lose its effectiveness as well. This is indirectly confirmed by the fact that the United States Army started to actively test the new M7 rifle and the more powerful 6.8x51 cartridge to replace the M4 and 5.56. What's more, almost no one knows about that, but Russia is doing the same thing. Recently, the Kalashnikov concern introduced a new AK-22 rifle and 6.02x41 cartridge. It has a higher recoil, but it is superior to the 545 and 762 in terms of velocity and kinetic energy. In a nutshell, the new rounds are effective on a distance up to 800 meters, whereas the old ones were only effective on up to 400. As far as external differences are concerned, for now we can only see a larger magazine. In addition to the basic 6.02x41, the project also includes three more cartridges: 6.7x45, 6.5x39 and 6.49. And interestingly enough, the AK model for the latter cartridge was introduced back in 2015. Apparently, they will try to make the transition to the new ammunition keeping the familiar AK platform, as it was done 50 years ago. That's all for today. I hope it was interesting. Thanks everyone for watching. See you all around.